Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. As you guys can tell by the title, today I'm going to be showing you guys how to do a DIY romper with a train. I did wanted to do one of these for my niece in a while, so I did Google some pictures, and they usually don't sell these for kids. They usually do sell them for adults. So I wanted to make my own for her. So the floral dress with the red flowers, my mom did give it to me because she didn't want it anymore. And the black dress, I did buy it at a thrift store. If you do buy clothes at a thrift store, I do recommend washing your clothes before using it. So there's that. So I'm gonna be showing you guys how I cut the fabric, how I do everything. Sorry, that was my niece. So yeah, I'm gonna be showing you guys how I do everything in the video. I hope you guys enjoy. You guys have been asking for these types of videos. So yeah, I hope you guys enjoy it. This is my first, so bear with me. I hope the ankles are great, and I hope you guys enjoy it. So this is one of the dresses that I'm gonna be using. From this dress, I'm only gonna be using the chiffon floral skirt because that's what I'm gonna be using to create the train for the romper. And then I found this dress at a thrift store. I'm going to be using this entire dress. I'm going to be using the skirt form to do the romper. And I'm going to be using the bodice from this dress as well. But first, you are going to need some scissors. You are going to need a measuring tape, a fabric slicer, a pencil, and your templates on your sides of the romper or shorts and everything that you're going to use to create whatever you're going to create. And obviously yarn and pins. And the most important, your hands. First, I'm going to grab the black dress that I bought at a thrift store. Make sure you do wash it. And I'm just going to be grabbing my slicer and cutting off the bodice from the dress. And I'm going to be working with the bodice first. I'm going to turn it inside out. And I'm going to grab the template and just mark where I have to sew. I'm just using some pins just to mark it right now. Then I'm going to be removing the seams from the skirt. I'm using the skirt part of that same black dress I bought at a thrift store just to make it into like two pieces. Then I'm going to fold it in half and then put the shorts template on top because you do need two separate pieces and you need two sets. So you are going to have four pieces, but you're not going to remove them. So you just need two sets of four of these same shapes. Then you're going to just use your slicer. I like using a slicer just because it is faster. And this is the second piece I'm cutting. Obviously, you are cutting it in fold because you need two pieces. Then I'm going to be cutting the waistband. This is what's going to attach the shorts to the bodice. Just to make that little waist look a little bit cinched. Not a lot because she is a little girl, so she doesn't need that body. And then these are all the things you need. The shorts, the bodice, and the waistband. I'm not going to be cutting the chiffon skirt yet. I'll do that at the end. And I'm just going to be sewing down where I place the pins. I'm just using a stretch stitch, which is a zigzag stitch, because you don't want your seam to pop, because this is a very stretchy fabric. If you do want it to not stretch as much, then you do go ahead and use a straight stitch. But for this bodice, I'm using a zigzag stitch because I want it to stretch, and it gives it a little bit more stretch because she's a little bit chubby. So now I'm going to be grabbing two pieces of the sew shorts, and I'm just going to be sewing down the crotch area, just the crotch area. And I am using a straight stitch because I don't want this crotch area to stretch, so I want it to stay in place. So I'm sewing both of the sets just down the crotch area how I showed you guys. And then you're going to open both pieces and match up the middle seams, and then just match up the side seams and then pin it down. Make sure they are the same size or else they will look wonky and crooked. So you make sure you are matching it really, really, really good and then pinning them down. And you're just gonna sew down the side seams as I'm showing you guys here. And I'm using a straight stitch, not a stretch stitch, because I don't want the shorts to stretch a lot because I want it to be more fitted to the body. So using a straight stitch will help not stretch the fabric a lot. And this is a stretch fabric, so it'll stretch a little bit, but not much. Now I'm just gonna be matching the seams in the middle from the crotch area and then just pinning down to close the crotch area. It's the smallest part of the sewing, so I'm just using the same a straight stitch to close the crotch area. Then you turn the shorts right sides out, and then you check if everything looks good. Then I'm going to be going in and sewing the feet. I'm just going to sew, I'm going to measure it on her first and then cut wherever I need to cut, and just sew an inch seam allowance in the bottom just so it looks clean and it doesn't look like I just cut it off. I do recommend doing this because it will look cleaner, and obviously it is a romper, so you do want to shorten the leg area because you want to be sexy, because you're really not going to tell because you are going to be wearing a train. So obviously do whatever you want, but I think it looks better if you do sew the bottom. Then I'm going to turn them inside together and then just put them to the side now because I'm going to be going into the waistband. I'm just going to sew the sides of the waistband using a straight stitch. Doing the same thing to both sides. You do want to measure to your bodice before and then cut excess fabric if you need to. And then you're going to be putting it over your bodice. I'm just going to be putting it over my bodice and just pinning around that area. I'm going to be matching the side seams first just because so it can match, so it won't look wonky when she has it on. And then once she has it when I have it all pinned up, I'm just going to be sewing it together. And that's it. I'm using a straight stitch for everything. I just use a stretch stitch for the bodice. Now I'm going to be measuring 2 inches away from the crotch area, and then it's going to be like 4 inches altogether, and that's where I'm going to be placing the train on the shorts. First, I'm going to be showing the train to the shorts because that's going to be the easiest for you. So I'm just going to be pinning it. I did use a gather stitch just to gather the chiffon, and then I distributed it all around the shorts just so it could be kind of like flowy, because she kind of likes those kind of things. And then just pin it around those shorts. I'm going to be showing it set right sides together because I'm going to be sewing the waistband at the end. So that's going to hide the stitching. So right here, I'm just sewing the train to the shorts only. Make sure you do sew it to the shorts first, because if you have any mistakes, you could just go back and do the seams. And then once you cut it, I'm going to turn it, I'm going to turn the shorts inside out. The bodice, I'm going to turn it inside out and then match up the waistband, not the bodice, the waistband to the shorts. And once you sew it over it, it's going to hide the stitching when you attach the train to the shorts. So when you turn it, when you turn the bodice in right sides out, you won't see that stitching around the waist from the shorts. So it's gonna hide it and it's gonna look clean. And then once you're done stitching it, this is where I show you guys to sew the waistband to the shorts. Once you're done stitching it, you do want to zigzag to just clean up the edges, and this is the way it looks. And I thought it was missing something, so I went back to the extra fabric, the black dress, and I did some little sleeves because it's kind of cold right now, so I wanted to not be so naked because it was going to be like sleeveless. But I went back and I did some bell sleeves, so I cut 3 pieces in 3 different sizes, and I did sew them together. I did hem the bottom, and then I did attach all 3 of them in one, and then I sewed them all together because I wanted to have like a layering bell sleeve because I like the way they look. I don't know why, but I have a thing with bell sleeves. I feel like they look very, very pretty. And then I'm just going to sew them together. And this is just a little waist thing that's going to go around her arm. This is the part that I regret doing. I shouldn't have had done this part because I could have just added the bell sleeves to the bodice. But I don't know, in my head, I thought I needed like a band to go around her arm. But in reality, you don't. But it still looked cute, and I didn't want to go back and hem it because I already had hemmed it. So this is how they look. I did sew two, and I just attached it to the side seams, both of them, and then just hand stitched it. And that is the end of the video, guys. And I will be showing you guys a montage when she's wearing the romper.
find the look. I hope you guys enjoy watching this DIY romper with a dress. I don't know how many times I've said that in this video, but I hope you guys really did enjoy this video. You guys have been asking me to do videos like these because you guys do see my Insta stories all the time that I've been making clothes for my niece. And if you guys want more videos like these, then leave me comments down below. Please don't forget to subscribe to this channel and like this video and hit that ring bell notification bell sign to get notified when I upload new videos. All the products used in this video will be down below. And I will be back doing makeup tutorials very soon. I love you guys so much, and thank you guys so much for supporting me. And I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye, guys.